Hey guys, what's up? And welcome to another Minecraft video. Today I wanted to do a little bit of a bonus episode for you because we were doing some building on, or I was doing some building on the Octa-Core, doing some of the design aesthetics on the inside, but I didn't really want to do it for an actual full-on video. So I decided, why not do brew and build time lapses to occasionally show you what I do behind the scenes. So it's a little bit of a bonus episode. Today we're working on the interior of the Octa-Core, getting sort of the foundation laid for a design. And I gotta say, by the end of it, I think this is gonna be a really, really cool building. It's gonna be a really cool interior. As you can see down there, there is sort of a little gate opening with the droppers being kind of the holes where they go down. And so that's kind of how I'm envisioning the entrance to these little sectors here. Right now I'm just building up the actual sort of exterior. And one thing I wanted to say with this is I'm building out and making the walls 2 to even 3 thick. And that's because we have plenty of space to do that. I would say if you're doing a build this big, feel free to build as far out as you need to make it actually work. Because I was afraid at first of using up too much space, but this build is so massive that it really, really does not matter. Now here on the side, we are working on sort of the entrance area, and this actually is the only entrance that's fully complete. The one that we did previously quite a while ago is actually not even fully complete. And this one actually has a new design thing that I've put in that you'll see in a sec that I actually really think adds quite a bit to this. Now I did forget to, I think, go back and add in all of the stone brick stairs on the roof interior, but that's okay. But as you can see, so I first started off with windows, and I was kind of like, this looks good, but there's something off about it. It needs a little bit more oomph to it. So I decided let's add some flowers to add sort of a break in the middle to kind of make it so it's a not just one giant flat surface. And I think this adds so much to it. Now here we're gonna be getting into a sort of a dock type of thing. Originally the idea I had when I was making this was, oh, we're gonna have ships coming in to unload cargo and stuff here. So we need to have a little bit of a dock area. But I think I'm gonna go back on that idea. And I think what we're gonna have is instead sort of a train of large minecart type things, large, I'm not sure what to call it, but like trolleys on rails that are sort of, they run between the cargo district, the like harbor district area, and the Octa-Core, and transporting all the goods and stuff to the various different towns in this big giant warehouse. And so as you can see here, I decided I needed it to be bigger. I don't know if this is gonna stay. I think it's a cool design and I think it looks good. So it may stay, but I'm just not really sure at this point because I just don't know exactly how I want to do that sort of trolley unloading system. Now here I'm just starting to get in to working on the sort of the design of the arch itself, and just putting in some fences and some cobbles, some walls, and putting in some lanterns to light it up. Because in shaders, it's not that pleasing to see giant dark spots. So decided to add some stuff. And oh yes, I forgot. We have a new villager. And it's actually really nice because not a ton of mobs spawn. So when a villager zombie does spawn, they don't really have any like competition. I don't have to run around. And oh, I forgot that this the camera doesn't like to stop in one spot. It likes to kind of bounce back and forth. So that's why I did that. But there we go. There's our villager. And now I decide to build up his house. And I think it's looking pretty good by the end of it. I mean, it's definitely temporary. You should let me know. Should we do a bunch of those little floating houses that we've got Fix-It Felix in? Because I like having those, and those could be cool maybe on the outskirts where they're kind of floating in the suburbs, where they're similar to like a city in a suburb area where you have like the nice houses, and then you've kind of got those small dinky nice houses that are a little different, but they're like the poorer versions, if you will. And then of course you have to boat them around and stuff, and there he is, he's going. I need a name for this person. I think I already recorded the next episode of Brew and Build. It's gonna be good. I think you're gonna like it. But I need a name for this guy. So if you have a name, that would be awesome. I would love to hear your suggestions. And here I'm just kind of swapping through, trying to figure out what sort of not mending villager, librarian I want. I think he's an efficiency 5 villager now. And so that's really good. We've got mending and efficiency 5. Now we just need unbreaking 3 and we'll be set for any pickaxes that break. Oh, I did break a pickaxe. I don't remember which one of Black Silk's, I think it was Black Silk twice removed was the one that bit the dust. I was mining stone. I didn't pay attention, but it's okay. We have 4 others. And so currently I think we're using Black Silk's Uncle Harold is what I've named the current Silk Touch pickaxe. So yeah, I don't know. Here we're just getting into the design of the roof. This was a little interesting because I wasn't sure. I didn't really want to put a ton of detail into the roof because it's so high up there and it does get moderately dark that I really was not sure what I wanted to do. And so I decided, well, let's just make it simple like the outside, but let's add a wood framing around it. Oh, this is insane. Watch this skeleton. Look at this dude. This is insane. I could not hit him for the life of me. Like, this man was the most ninja skeleton I've ever seen. And he manages to actually kill me. And watch me. I just smash my face. I start to fly and boom, dead. Ugh, it was so sad. At least the skeleton died, but that was impossible. Impossible for me to actually hit that stupid skeleton. And now here we're getting into the diagonal portion of the sort of the storage area. And I gotta say, I love how this turned out. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do because diagonals are always difficult to sort of figure out. And I'm really glad I put these big beams going down because I think it really has helped. One, structurally, look sound. But two, it helped add a little bit of depth to be able to work with. And so we kind of have this alternating like three glass block window and then a section where there's only flowers and then another window and then flowers and then another window. And it looks really good. So now we're just gonna get into a quick overview of everything. And I think it's all turned out really, really nice. I really love how everything looks. This is gonna look really, really cool, I think, once all of the different sides on the inside are done. It's gonna be a nice complete picture that we've been working for. And I think that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. I hope you have enjoyed, and I hope you enjoyed this sort of bonus episode. Let me know what your thoughts are on that down below in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next video.